Having Megan back, it's different, as you can see, two goals difference. I mean, she's incredible. You know, she's, I would say, one of the best players in the world, hands down. I always knew she's good, but now I have a pretty good idea how good she is, and I'm very happy that she's on my team.
Coach, what were your overall thoughts on the game tonight?
I thought it was a good game, good performance. I thought we played intense and quick, and we were able to expose some of the areas that we thought that we can take advantage of, and obviously the creativity of the players that we have was tremendous, and we scored good goals.
Can you comment on your team's performance in the early season schedule, where you had such a lengthy period of time between home matches, periods of time off, but you've come through it with 13 points and are in really nice shape?
Yes, obviously, look, you know, when we were looking at the schedule before the season, it wasn't something that we were very thrilled about, but we didn't moan about it. We didn't cry about it. We just knew that we had to figure out a way to deal with it. And I have to say that the players have been true warriors. I mean, they've worked hard and they've traveled all over the country. You know, we played three East Coast teams in the four away games, and I thought that we've performed well. And one thing that makes me happy is that we've gotten better every game. And the mistakes that we made in the previous games, they didn't show in the next game.
Next question is on your goalkeeper situation. You had the first five matches where Michelle played. Tonight you've got Williams back. In all circumstances, your team has gone with clean sheets in the first half across. Are we going to see a rotation? How is that going to come about, because you've got effective goalkeeper play from both?
Yes, I can say that I'm very fortunate to have two great goalkeepers on the team, and we're going to see both of them at different games, and it will be purely tactical decision, because right now I cannot determine one or the other to be starter or backup goalkeeper. You know, they're both starter goalkeeper quality, and they have been great. I mean, you know, Michelle with some of the games that she had, and we see Lydia coming in doing just as well. All I can say is it makes me happy. It makes me happy that I have a great goalkeepers with slightly different technical abilities, and that will give us different ways to expose teams.
Overall, how did it feel to finally to have a game back at home, just in front of the home crowd, and on the occasion of celebrating Jesse's 100th games?
Yes, first Jesse's 100 games milestone. I think it's incredible. You know, just to have someone like Jess Fishlock in this league. I'm not even talking about this team. Just to have a player her quality on this team is tremendous. I mean, she brings a lot to this team, but brings a lot to the league as well. So I'm just happy that I have a chance to work with a player of her caliber, and excited to be able to work with her. In terms of the playing a home game, we treated it like another home opener. I mean, the last time we played at home, it was so far away that it was another home opener for us. And I'm very happy that we could put up a good show for the fans. And I think that people and our fans can start getting a little glimpse every game, more and more, a better glimpse of what this team is all about and what we can do.
And to speak on that, finding out glimpses of more, like going through the process, like you said last week, this is your third straight game of starting McNabb and Oyster as your center backs. Is it still a case of like going with the hot hand for them as your pair, or is it still, like you said, through the process of trying to figure out what would be your ideal?
Yes, I'm just happy that as a team, we have an option. We have options. I mean, we have... as you know, if we're talking center backs, we have Lou Barnes and Matty Bauer, two great center backs. I mean, they can come in, or one or both, in any point in time. We have Kristen Westfall, who started in the previous games, and now we have Teresa Nilsson back, you know, two great players. And we have Alyssa Kleiner there. I think that she's someone that can bring a different dynamics to our team. And then, you know, we talk in the middle, Morgan Andrews is there, Bev Yanez, who a starter, didn't start this game, you know, she's going to be back, and Jess Spencer. I mean, we have options, and that's what makes me happy. It's tougher for me because I have to make some hard decisions, but ultimately that's what it's all about, you know, internal competition so we can bring the best out of every player.
The first goal was set up by a Steph Catley cross. The second goal was a deflection off of a Steph Catley yeah. cross. In the second half, she overlapped again and sent a through ball that led to a corner kick. What kind of freedom do you give your defenders to overlap an attack or not? Is it tactical? Where does that fit?
Obviously, both of our fullbacks are very attacking minded, and that's something that we've talked a lot. We identify ourselves as a triple A team, what we call it, attacking, aggressive, and attractive soccer. And part of it being attacking is the fullbacks to go forward. You know, Steph Catley, I think that we'll see a lot more of her and doing stuff like that. Just having someone like her, you know, incredible left foot, great soccer mind, and incredible distribution. I think that she's gonna be able to set a lot more goals for us. I hope.